miracle night. Need a miracle? Your miracle is here today, right now. Welcome to Miracle Night. Your miracle is here. Your host, Prophet Jason Lepard. Hello, guys. I'm going to be talking about something tonight. And by the way, guys, you can tune in on our radio station, too. You can tune in on the radio station. We're live on Facebook at God Saving Ministries. We're live on, where else we're live? YouTube on the Kingdom Network TV. You can log on there. You can log on anywhere and watch tonight. Or you can go on our website and tune in live on the radio. We're live on the radio right now. So you can listen to us on the radio station at www.thekingdomradio.com and listen to us anywhere. But let's get into this. We're going to be talking about the power of God's mercy. The power of God's mercy. And I'm going to try to get this thing pulled up right quick, guys. I know this is quite interesting right here, but I can't get my logos pulled up for some reason. Hold on, guys. Let me get this logos pulled up. I might have to get it on my tablet, guys. Okay. So, hand me my tablet, baby. This thing ain't going too good. All righty, guys. Alrighty, guys. Somebody said you're a lucky woman. Thank you, guys. You're flattering me, you know, but I like my wife to tell me that. All right, guys, I'm having to get the tablet right quick. Sorry about that. For some reason, it's... I was hoping my look. Here we go. I got it. Never mind. I got it, guys. This computer is going slow for some reason. I don't know why. All right, guys. We're going to be talking about the mercies of God. The mercy of God. And I know sometimes I gotta take some echo out of this for some reason. Let's get some echo out, guys. Sorry about this, guys. I'm new at a lot of this stuff, especially this internet radio broadcast here. There we go. Well, it's still got a bass into it. I don't know. There we go. No? That didn't take the bass out. Hold on, guys. Hold on. Let's see. Now, there we go. I took it out a little bit, but oh well. All right, guys. Took the ringing noise. There's a ringing noise for some reason. But anyways, we're gonna be going over the mercies of God, and I lost track there for a minute. So, we're trying to go live here too, brothers and sisters, but I don't think it is, but we'll record it. It's trying to go live, but if it don't, it's okay. We got poor internet connection here, guys, so It's probably not going to go live on Facebook. If it don't, it don't, it don't. So right now you can go on the radio and listen to us live at www.thekingdomradio.com. You just go on there and listen to us. We're on live right now. So, okay. We're going to be talking about the mercies of God. The mercy of God. What is the mercy of God? God has mercy on everyone. I say God has mercy on everyone. I'm telling you, he sent his son to us to have mercy on us. He sent his son to us to have mercy upon us. Do you understand that sometimes we don't realize how much God's mercy has for us? He sent his son to us to have mercy, guys. We fail to realize something. We fail to realize that God has mercy on us. You know why he has mercy on us? Because mankind got deceived because they didn't know which is evil. God only told them, don't touch the tree of good and evil. And what did they do? They went ahead and done the very thing God didn't tell them to do. But the lesson in that was to listen to God and quit trying to figure things out. We love to figure things out. I know we do. We all do. We all love to figure stuff out when we cannot figure it out. We can't understand why God still loves us when we deserve judgment. But even though man loved to judge us, when God loves to have mercy. Why is it that man don't have mercy, but God does? And the demonstration of it was when Jesus walked up to the woman that was caught in the midst of adultery. She was caught in the very act. And they wanted to pick up stones, the very ones that had sins. Let me tell you something tonight. Everybody watching me and hearing me tonight has a sin. I can tell you that right now. You have a sin, and I can tell you do, and I can tell you have more sin if you're judgmental. Why is that? Because you try to look good and put on a facade for yourself when all in all, you got more problems than your whole neighborhood. You got more problems than everybody around you. This is the very reason why we need to stop judging people. And Jesus even stated, judge not lest you be judged. The measure you judge, it'll be judged back to you. Why do we fail to listen to this? So what if you catch me in that? So what if you catch me? So what if I done wrong? Hadn't everybody done wrong? Romans 10:9 said, for all have come short of the glory of God. There ain't nobody on here can point fingers to nobody. There's nobody on here that can point fingers to nobody. Nobody. Nobody can point fingers to anyone. What we fail to realize is this. What we fail to realize is this. We deserve judgment when God decided to have mercy upon us. Is anybody hearing me out there in Radio Land or TikTok or Facebook? Are you hearing me? I'll tell you one thing, what we fail to realize is this. We fail to realize that God has mercy on us when men have judgment. Let me tell you guys something. Jesus demonstrated it when they decided to pick up stones and judge the woman. Do you understand why God even has mercy on us? I'll tell you why he does, my friend. Because number one, we was deceived. Watch this. We were deceived into believing a lie. We was deceived and to believe in evil and knowing evil when God didn't want us to know evil. It isn't like we had a choice. We was deceived in it. I said we was deceived in that. We was deceived into knowing a lie. It ain't like we was forced into it. We was not forced into it. We was deceived into it. Otherwise, we was tricked. And that's why God sent his son to have mercy on us, because he wanted to give us another chance to know the truth. And he sent the truth. Who was the truth? It's not the word, it's Jesus. Jesus said, I am the truth, I am the life, and I am the way. He had to send the truth. What was the truth, guys? Mercy stepped in when we deserved hell. My God, I don't think some of you are getting this. You're letting it go right over your head. You deserve hell every day. And sometimes God, watch this, sometimes God will let you see yourself and how unrighteous you really are. God will let you see how weak you are. God, I'm weak. God, there's no good thing inside of me. God, there's not no good thing. It's you that causes me to be good. It's you that causes me to bear fruit. It's you, God. And why do we fail to realize that? God will let you fall flat to your face. God will let you fall flat to your face just to show you who you are and who he is. Why does God have to do that? Because God wants us to realize our need for him and our need for ourselves. That's why we decided in the garden that we didn't need God, that we could make one wise and be wiser than God. So we didn't need God. That was the first temptation that man failed from the beginning. Oh, so you don't need God? Oh, so you don't need God? Let me tell you something, my friend. I need him every day. Listen, I am so weak without him. I am so weak without him. Listen, I am so weak that I can't even stand. I like that song, I can't even walk without him holding my hand. God's mercy come down the earth because we were weak and we were vulnerable to everything. We were vulnerable to everything. This is what we fail to realize as mankind. We fail to realize this, guys. Here's what we fail to realize. God's mercy is new every morning. And I'm going to show you that. Let's get in some scripture right quick. Guys. God wants, number one, God wants us to be merciful. We got to understand his mercy. Why he has mercy upon mankind. I just told you why. Because mankind got deceived. Come on. And he has mercy upon them. And a lot of people, he understands why. Now, I'm not giving you the license to go sin, guys. That's not what I'm doing. I'm showing you the love of God. The Bible says you know that you have passed from darkness unto light when you have love for one for another. But how can you have love for somebody when you don't understand why they're doing the things they're doing? Come on, guys. I have a friend in Middle Old Florida. I know he don't mind me sharing this, but I have a friend in Middle Old Florida. His name's Jackie. Everybody left him when they found some bad stuff on him. They left him, but I didn't. You know why? Because I understood why he was doing them things. And see, that's why God has mercy upon us, because he understands what makes us do them things. Now, We should not take his mercy for granted. No, that's not what I'm saying. But God's got to love you before you can love him. Well, Jason, he died 2,000 years ago. You understand, he's already loved us. Yeah, but you wasn't there. You wasn't there. Maga. See, you wasn't there. You wasn't there when he saved you. You wasn't there when he died for you. So how do you know and how can you fall in love with something that you hadn't had a relationship with now? Listen, God is calling you now to have a relationship now. He wants to reveal himself to you and make himself real to you so he can have that personal relationship with you guys. My Lord. Listen, I'm telling you guys something. God wants a personal relationship with you. Let's go to some scriptures, guys. Matthew 5:7, blessed are the merciful, for they shall attain what? Mercy. See, God is calling us to have mercy like he has mercy on us. Guys, God has mercy on us all the time. His mercy is new every morning. If you've messed up today, tomorrow his mercy is new. Man's mercy will hold a grudge on you 10, 20 years from now. But God will forgive you tomorrow and it's like nothing's done. God will forget it. He forgives our sins from the east and west. You know what that means? He does not remember it no more. Now he wants us to be merciful like he's merciful. Here's the thing that I had a problem with. I knew God loved me and I loved God, but I had problem loving people like God loves me. And that's what he's called you to do. Love others like I have loved you. Guys, we got to start loving people like God loves us. Boy, we need a check tonight, don't we? We need a check tonight because we don't love nobody. Listen, we hold grudges on everybody. We throw rocks at everybody. And let a Christian make a mistake for God's sake, and you'll put him upside down and crucify him. Listen, you're evil. You're evil. That's what you are. You're evil. But Luke 6:35-36, but let love your enemies, do good to them, hope in them, for nothing again, your reward shall be great. And you shall be the children of the Most High God, and for he is kind unto them unthankful, for he is kind unto the unthankful and to the evil. See, there's some evil people come on here tonight, and I'm grateful you guys are here. Thank you for being here. See, if I can't love them guys, how can I love God? Listen, you gotta love evil people too. My. Be ye therefore merciful as your Father is also merciful. Let me tell you how to be merciful over somebody, guys. I'm going to teach you something. I'm fixing to give you a nugget of being merciful over your neighbor. Let me tell you something. A lot of times people act that way for a reason. You know that? So a lot of times they're real pushy against people for a reason. Listen, maybe the person that you're enemy with, maybe they're that way for a reason. Find out the reason what made them that way. And then you can see how to have mercy on them. Because you'll never find mercy on no one if you don't realize what causes him to be that way. That's what I did with my friend Jackie. See, everybody was judging him over a matter. But see, I had mercy upon him because I understood where he was coming from. See, that's why God has mercy on us, guys. I said, that's why God has mercy on us. Do you understand? Watch this, guys. Luke 10:25-37, and behold, a certain lawyer stood up and tempted him, saying, Master, what shall I do unto the inheritance of eternal life? He said unto him, it is written the law. How readest thou? All right, guys, let's also go down here right quick. It says in Luke 6:36, be you therefore merciful as your Father is also merciful. Guys, the only thing God wants us to do when we begin to love God and God begins to love us, he wants us to love them like he's loving us. See, God's merciful. He's forgiven. You know what I'm saying? He's forgiveness. He wants you to repent now. He wants you to be sorry for what you just done. But the thing is, don't continue your, listen, it's okay to fall, but it's really bad when you stay down. I'm telling you, it's really bad when you stay down. Watch this, guys. I want you guys to see something here. John 14:21. He that keepeth my commandment, he that has my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father. And I will love him, and I will manifest myself to him. See, guys, his commandments is to love your neighbor as yourself. Listen, love your neighbor as yourself. Listen, guys, I'm telling you, this is such, we don't have mercy on no one. We don't have mercy on nobody, and we don't love nobody either. All we want to do is pick out the pointing finger all the time. We want to pick out the pointing finger all the time. We want to throw the stones all the time. That's all we want to do. We don't want to have mercy. We don't want to have mercy on nobody. We don't want to have mercy on anybody. So we pick out these stones. We pick out these stones. And just throw them at people. And you know, we don't have no mercy. None whatsoever. I'm talking about none. We have no mercy on no one. We have no mercy. I said, we have no mercy. Are you understanding me tonight? Because I think some of you, this is going over your head. We do not have mercy on no one. And you know what? If you want to get close to him, and just like I read you this, I'm going to read it one more time. He that has my commandments and keepeth them. What is his commandments? Love God with all your heart, then love your neighbor. Listen, you can't love your neighbor if you don't know how to love God. Come on, guys, come on. When you love God, you'll know how to love your neighbor. And see, that's why he gave you those two commandments. And those two commandments will sum all of it up, of the whole 10 commandments. Because those two commandments Jesus gave us is to love the Lord, the God, with all your heart, mind, body, and soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. Listen, guys, you can't love your neighbor when you don't know how to love God. My, 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 my. You got to know how to love God first, guys. I said you got to know how to love God first. Watch this. He that has my commandments and keepeth them, he is that loveth me, and he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father. And I will love him, and I will manifest myself to him. It's all about a love relationship. Guys, that's all it is. God left you a love letter. It's called the Bible. That's all he did. He left you a love letter, and now he wants to pursue a relationship. Ain't that wonderful? My, 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 my. Listen to this, guys. Romans 5:5-8. And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given to us, for when we were without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. In 1 Corinthians 13, though I speak with the tongues. And the reason why I'm talking about love, guys, because it ties into mercy. Listen, mercy and love works together. Come on. Listen, love and mercy works together because mercy stepped in and said, you know what? I know you guys deserve a hell, but I'm going to send my son because I have mercy on you. And you know what? I'm going to send my son to die on that cross. And when he dies, it is finished. All you got to do is come get it. Come on. All you got to do is come get it. He said, those who are leavened and heavy laden, come unto me and I'll give you rest. Come on, guys. The mercy is here tonight. I said the mercy is here. In 1 Corinthians 13, though I speak with the tongues of man of angels and I have not charity, I become a sounding brass and a tingling cymbal. And though I give all my gift, though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith, so I could move mountain, and I have not charity, I'm nothing. Do you understand tonight God is calling us to have a relationship with him and start loving people into the kingdom of God? Do you understand that God wants us to quit pointing the finger and quit judgmental spirits and start loving people and say, you know what, brother? I know you are porn. I know you watch porn, but it's all right. I'm still going to be your friend, and we're going to pray this through. Come on. What we want to do is leave them high and dry. Let me tell you something. Jesus didn't leave you high and dry. I can prophesy over phone numbers, brother. Oh, God gives me all the mysteries. I don't care what God gives you. When you don't have love, you're nothing. You're a stingling brass cymbal. You get on God's nerves. And it takes maturity to love like this, guys. Maturity. Not some childish, immature Christian. That's what Paul said. I once was a child, I spoke as a child, but I became a man. See, you got to become a man to love. You got to become a man to walk in this kind of love. You got to become a man. See, God is looking for men and women of God to grow up in the kingdom of God. Grow up. In Galatians 5:14 through 22, for all the law is filled in one word, even in this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. But if you bite, devour one another, take heed that you be not consumed of one another. In Galatians 5:22-23, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance, such there is no law. I'm going to read that to you one more time, guys. Galatians 5:22-23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love. Do you understand if you're not bearing fruit, God will cut you off? You understand if you're not going to bear fruit and you're going to be judgmental and you're going to be criticizing and religious, got this religious spirit, they don't go to my church, then I'm not going to hang with them. You hypocrite and you loser, because God is not going to put up with that no more. Let me tell you something. God is tired of the stuff. He's tired of these people. I go to church every Wednesday, bless God. I go to church every Sunday, bless God. Yeah, but you don't love your neighbor when you go home. Come on. You don't even ask your neighbor, do you want something to eat? You don't even ask your neighbor next door. You don't ask your neighbor. It's time to love, guys. God's tired of the hypocrite stuff. You want to know why some of these people on TikTok talk like this? Tell me. You know why some people are against God? Because look at the Christians. They're not shining no light. All they're doing is sitting in a darn church, and they're not shining no light. They are meaner than the world. Come on. I can go to a bar, and a drunk man would be nicer than a darn Christian. What is wrong with us, people of God? We've become hypocrites. That's what we've become. They can't see no light because you ain't being one. What you know when you come to the Father, you know you've come to darkness to light when you have love one for another. All we want to do is judge them. We don't even want to go out in the world and be with them and be friends with them. Jesus was friends of sinners, guys. My Lord, where are we going to? But the fruit of the Spirit is love. If you don't start bearing fruit, God's going to cut you off. What did he do to the fig tree? Why did Jesus curse the fig tree? Because it wouldn't bear no fruit. Watch this, guys. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, and meekness and temperance. Against there is such no law. Uh-oh, I'm going to talk to the husbands a little bit. Mercy, husbands. I know your wife gets on your nerves and she's not perfect, but God is calling men tonight to do this. In Ephesians 5, 25 through 28, husbands, love your wives even as Christ also loved the church. My God, you got to love her when she's not perfect. Come on, you got to love her in her flaws and failures. You got to say, baby, you know what? You ain't perfect, but you know what? I still love you. I still love you if you're not. I still love you if you don't meet up to the standards that I want you to meet up to. I still love you. Gave himself for it that it might be sanctified and cleansed it by the washing, by the water, by the word. Watch this. 1 John 4, 7 through 16. Beloved, let us also love one another for the love of God, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God. Ain't that something? Praise God, praise God. And you got to know, love covers a multitude of sin. You're not going to walk up to somebody and begin to judge them of their sin. You're just going to love them right in their sin. Just like he did you, bless God. He didn't come to you telling you, Jason, you got to do this, you got to do that. But the more he loved me, the more I wanted to change. Come on. The more I wanted to change, bless God. And when we fail to realize, this is what we fail to realize. God's love will change us when we have this relationship. He said, 1 John 4, 7 through 16, beloved, let us love one another, for God is of love, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. My, we in check tonight. Listen, guys, that's all I have. That is all I have. Holy Ghost just shut me off just like that. He said, listen, son, that's it. Let's wrap it up. All right, guys, if you want to give, here we go. Jump in the
hurdles. If you would like to sow tonight, you can do so at www.paypal.me/Jason Leopard. Or if you have a Cash App, you can download our Cash App on the Apple Market or Google Market, Google Play. You can get it, sow a seed at $GodSavingMinistries. Or you can partner with us on our website at www.GodSavingMinistries.com/partnership. Thank you for sowing. We appreciate your general offering. God bless you.
All right, guys. All right. You heard it. And you can also sow, too, on the Kingdom Radio, thekingdomradio.com. You can go on there and give, too. We got buttons on there, too. Listen, we need you guys to support. Listen, this radio station is, I'm telling you, God has gave me a vision out of this world. Radio station, TikTok, Facebook. Listen, guys, we are trying to reach people for God. Why are we doing this? Because we want them to have a relationship like we do. God bless you guys. Y'all have a wonderful evening. God bless you.